Welcome to TokenPost Daily News Briefing, where we provide the latest and exclusive news on blockchain and cryptocurrency. On our top stories, we have Fortnite, the launch of BAKKT, and the skepticism of Wall Street Journal and the founder of Stellar. Stay tuned for more. I'm your host, Sun, and this is your Daily News Briefing. Fortnite has ranked the top list among gamers for the past years, and its entering the Korean market has shook the gaming world here in Korea as well. Another interesting news from the Fortnite community was that the official merchandise store of Fortnite will now be accepting Monero as its payment. According to the official website of merch.fortnite.com, among the given choices such as Visa, MasterCard, and PayPal, the company listed Monero as one of their available payment options. It's a surprise as there were no previous hints on Fortnite's partnership with a certain crypto company or their plans to launch a crypto-based payment system was released. While more are to be seen when it comes to the technical part of exchange rates and refunds, this definitely is an exciting news for both the crypto enthusiasts and the Fortnite players around the world. The Intercontinental Exchange, or ICE, has announced an update on BAKKT on December 31st on its official website. According to the announcement, ICE plans to consult with the American CFTC and provide an update on the launch timeline in the early 2019. The launch, which previously was scheduled to be announced on January 24th of 2019, was said to be postponed due to the CFTC's work progress and timeline. Created by the New York Stock Exchange, BAKKT is a physically settled daily futures contract for Bitcoin where it will be cleared by the Intercontinental Exchange. As mentioned, being a daily futures contract for physical settlement, the impact that this product would bring to the crypto world was chanted among traders. However, despite its news on finishing its first round of funding of $182 million, with this constant delays, it seems to have left the crypto world weary and impatient. Will we be seeing a concrete timeline for the launch of BAKKT Bitcoin in the coming January? While hopes are high, we'll just have to sit and wait for the coming future. Last May, the Georgia Bureau of Investigation has released news on a possible theft of computer equipment from the campaign office of State Senator Michael Williams. However, just a few days ago, it has been reported that the Senator Williams, who was a GOP candidate for governor, has filed a false report on the theft of the equipment itself. According to The Guardian, Michael Williams, who had been spotlighted for his deportation bus campaign tour, was indicted for not only committing an insurance fraud, but also lying to the officials on the break-in of his campaign office. To the accusation, Williams' attorney claimed innocent for his client, stating that the indictment merely represents a one-sided story presented by a group of people. While the details and whereabouts on the case are yet to be disclosed to the public, being harshly condemned for the deportation bus campaign, there don't seem to be much bright future in the coming days for Senator Williams. An article published by the Wall Street Journal pointed out to the lacking use case of real-life adoptions of cryptocurrency and blockchain. The article claimed that if you were to ask whether Bitcoin suited the hype of its past days, the majority would answer definitely no to the question. The article further went on to criticize the lacking usage of cryptocurrencies and blockchain, stating that it is largely usable only by developers themselves. It may be true that the hype brought the industry to the fame it does not deserve, however, the article acknowledges the institutional interest that lies within the crypto industry, quoting the launch of BAKKT as one of the notable milestones that the industry will face. For a growing tech industry, one should give time for development as well as the adoption of technology itself. However, despite comments made by the Wall Street Journal, as we enter 2019, hopes are high for this growing industry to change the way we trust and transact through this advancement of blockchain. An interesting interview was conducted by Yahoo Finance with Jed McCaleb, the co-founder and CTO of Stellar. During the interview, while revealing his skeptic perspective on the crypto industry today, he called BS to 90% of projects currently out in the market. On the interview, one for specific, McCaleb called out to Trome to be a garbage where people dump tons of money on something technically impossible. Moreover, he added that there exists no encompassing solution when it comes to the applicability of tokens, including Stellar Lumens themselves. However, his outlook on the general crypto market was positive. When asked about the bear market of 2018, he claimed that the crypto industry is still way up and that it has grown much more than he had anticipated. While throwing some sharp comments on the technical part of current projects, his stance was made clear. The hype brought the market up, and this led to the overflow of projects which simply was redundant. Now, it was indeed bold comment to those working hard to improve and come up with a new solution. On whether his comments would be true or not, I would say let the market decide. We bring the latest news to you. That was your TokenPost Daily News Briefing. I'm your host, Hun, and thank you for watching.